This week, we're on the Cal Don in the San Francisco Bay Area for some potluck fishing, and then we'll head to Tennessee for a tribute tournament on Kentucky Lake with the late Jerry Reed. And then we're fishing George Jones and Tanya Tucker's ponds with Country Music Hall of Famer, Little Jimmy Dickens. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television.
Hi, I'm Blair Pancake, Miss Tennessee 2006, and you are watching Angler West Television.
It's the 4th of July, and today we're on the California Don with Captain James Smith.
All right, get a little bait. We're gonna head up the Marin Coast. I'm gonna make an attempt to catch some live bait. Although we have a tank of live bait, we're gonna go up and try and catch some more bait, some bigger bait for Lingcod. And we'll head up here and poke around. Hasn't been fished too much this year since the season opened just a few days ago. So we should find some better weather and hopefully some decent fishing up here on both the Lingcod and the rockfish. Ideally, we're gonna get a tank load, maybe 100 to 150 kingfish to put on board the boat, and that should supply us with enough bait for the afternoon for when we're targeting the lings. They're gonna eat the anchovies, and we're gonna get our fair share on the anchovies, but the bigger ones are gonna tend to grab a bigger bait, and the kingfish seems to work pretty good up here, so hopefully we get enough here this morning to drag up the coast with us, and maybe we're gonna luck out in some big wings this afternoon.
Why don't we liberate these United States? We're the ones who need it worst. Let the rest of the world help us for change, and let's rebuild America first. Our highways and bridges are falling apart. Who's blessed and who has been cursed? There's things to be done all over the world, but let's rebuild America first.
Great, keep going. You'll keep going.
You don't expect me to work all day, do you? You got a one hang in your mic.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Look like he's picking up, Jake.
Hey. Wow, that's a nice one.
I think he'll keep.
Good job, man. Yeah, that's you, buddy.
It's a small cloud. That's not a lot as far as rockfish, but with the good little bit of structure around it, it provides some cover for perhaps some lingcod, maybe some larger fish. Since there's not a big area, most boats are gonna just pass over the area, which allows the fish here to grow, and you could get bigger fish, maybe not quite as many fish, but you can get larger fish in areas where you see a lot less on the meter. And that's just something I like to look for. Real small spots of fish, you can generally find a little better quality.
Got a good ling on here, starboard bow.
We'll Okay, everybody, it looks like we got limits of lings for everybody and pretty close on the rockfish as well. So let's go ahead and wind your lines up. We'll go ahead and sit back and just take a seat, order lunch, and we're gonna head inside or around the Golden Gate Bridge here and try for a little halibut and maybe some striped bass. So everybody get your gear off, sit back and relax. Gonna take about a 40-minute ride back into the bay.
Stacks of bait here, this bird that looks real fishy.
This spot I stopped in here, this is called Fort Cronkite. And I was actually heading to another spot, but I saw the birds diving and it looked promising, and I pulled in here. We saw a big spot of bait and I saw a few fish marking around the bait balls, and sure enough we dropped in, hooked a 20 plus pound striper right off the bat. So got me excited here. I think there's a few fish to be caught in this spot.
Why don't we liberate these United States? We're the ones who need it the most. You think I'm blowing smoke? Boys, it ain't no joke. I make 20 trips a year from coast to coast.
I'm Merle Haggard, and you're watching Angler West Television. Stay tuned. There's a lot of things coming.
I'm Justin Wolf.
And I'm Roland Martin, and you're watching Angler West Television.
Today, we're on Kentucky Lake, Tennessee, where the American Bass Association is holding a tribute tournament for members of the Screaming Eagles of the 101st Airborne, stationed close by at Fort Campbell, Kentucky. The soldiers have just returned from a tour of duty in Iraq, and bass anglers from as far away as Arizona have volunteered their time to take a soldier fishing as a way to say thanks for their service to our country. On the water today to greet and say thanks to the soldiers is country music and movie star Private First Class Jerry Reed.
Take me out on the water. Put a fishing rod in mine. Take me out on the water. Put a fishing rod in my hand. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow, maybe. I'm fishing today while I can.
My name's Jerry Reed. How y'all doing, soldier?
How you doing?
I'm doing good. Soldier?
How's it going, sir?
Are you gonna catch a fish or not?
Well, He caught the biggest one so far and lost it.
Lost it?
He lost about an 8-10 pound catfish right next to the boat.
Are you serious?
Well, he don't get excited about nothing. I guess that Iraq time got him all trained. He's all calm.
Hey, well, soldier, I want to tell you one thing. You know, you're looking at an old XPFC. I was in the Army in 1959 to 61. So me and you kind of joined at the hip. And I want to thank you for your service to our country. God bless you. I hope you catch a 12-pounder or anything. Hey, and by the way, it don't have to be a bass. If you'd have landed that fish, you'd have won it. I guarantee you.
Take me out on the water. Put a fishing rod in my hand. Take me out on the water. Put a fishing rod in my hand.
Hey, soldier. Look at me, I want to make a movie star out of you. How old are you, son?
Doing? 33.
I got underwear older than you, son.
I bet. Are you wearing them?
Not this morning.
Take me out on the water. Put a fishing rod in my hand.
Take me out on the water. Put a G. Lewis in my hand. Show me where the biting and you'll have yourself a mighty happy man.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Isn't that great? Look at that. Them screaming eagles, folks. They've just got back from a year's tour duty in Iraq. And American bass anglers were saying thank you for your service to our country and gave these great soldiers a day of fishing. My name's Jerry Reed, and I'm so proud to be involved in this and part of it because we owe so much to these soldiers and their families, the sacrifices they've made and are making and will make in the future. Wearing a uniform of the greatest country on earth. It makes me proud to be here.
At the weigh-in, all of the soldiers brought their fish to the scales with all species found in Kentucky Lake eligible in order to determine the winners of the three boats and other prizes.
This big fish, 4.83. Came back together, huh? All right. I do want to thank you and these people out here are going to give you a big hand for your service and your supporting us, okay? Thank you very much.
Hey, I'm CW2 Cogdell, 101st Airborne Division, 217 Cav. Just got back from Iraq about 20-something days ago. I found out about the American Bass Association trying to put, or bass anglers putting on this tournament for everybody that doesn't have a boat to come out here and link up with some professional fishermen. They take us out on the water and see if we can stir up some trouble. Weather was a little cold today, but we still managed to catch a couple fish. I've seen some pretty big turnout. A lot of soldiers came out of here. A lot of families are out here now. Absolutely had a ball. It was really nice just meeting some random guy, never met him before, and coming out here and just fishing with him and hearing some of his stories, swapping some of my stories from Iraq. Just great what they're doing for us. Coming back, it's a pretty warm welcome. Lots of free stuff for the soldiers, couldn't believe it. They give every soldier a pole, lots of free tackle, probably at least $150 worth of tackle. They're giving away three or four boats today to some lucky soldiers, so we'll see what happens. It's been pretty good, real good.
My name is Johnson Rollins. I'm a Chief Warrant Officer 3 in the United States Army. I'm stationed at Fort Campbell, Kentucky. My unit is USA MEDAC.
Turkey, and I've just been along for the ride today, and I've really enjoyed it. He's a tremendous fella. Glad to be associated with him.
I got to thank Mr. King, because if it wasn't him, I probably couldn't be able to win a Triton boat.
Hi, this is Ron Colby from Gary Yamamoto Custom Baits, and I just wanted to welcome home the 101st Airborne. Appreciate everything they're doing. I drove all the way from Page, Arizona to come out here and help this event, and I'd do it again in a heartbeat. And I sure want to thank everybody from the 101st for all the jobs they do.
The soldiers weighed in a wide variety of fish, including drum, sauger, and even a clam that I guess is close enough to being a fish. But in the end, it was the 56 largemouth bass that stole the show. The real show happened after the weigh-in with a USO-type production that included Miss Tennessee, Blair Pancake.
Hi, I'm Blair Pancake, Miss Tennessee 2006, and I am fortunate enough to be here in Paris, Tennessee, welcoming the 101st Airborne back to the States, back from Iraq, and we're out here having a wonderful time. They've been out fishing earlier, out in boats today, so I think they've enjoyed themselves, and I get to greet everybody and say hi and welcome home. It's been a wonderful day. A lot of people came out to support, very positive, and it's been a wonderful experience, so if you weren't here, you missed out, and if you were here, thanks for supporting.
After this break, we'll head down to the Nashville area to the homes of country music stars George Jones and Tanya Tucker to fish their ponds with Country Music Hall of Famer, Little Jimmy Dickens.
Hi, I'm Craig Morgan. You're watching Angler West Television.
Welcome back to Tennessee and the home of country music star George Jones. I'm Justin Wolf. George isn't home today, but his good friend, Little Jimmy Dickens, has come to fish his favorite fishing hole, the pond found on George Jones's estate.
The whole idea is to get the worm on the hook to where it doesn't work its way off. You gotta get it in several places because he's wiggling all the time he's in the water, and he'll wiggle his way off if you don't have him past that barb that's on the hook. I love to fish as long as I can remember, even from childhood in the mountains in West Virginia. We didn't have too many lakes or ponds until recent years. They have them now, but for many, many years, all we had was a little mountain streams, and you'd catch small fish, but nothing big, but it was fish, you know, and that's all we cared about, was catching fish with a little cane pole and worms. Taking Old Cold Tater was my first record, and then that particular year I was touring a lot with Hank Williams Sr. in concerts around the different areas of the country, and he just started calling me Tater, and before I knew it, all my friends were calling me Tater, and then it went to the fans, and I've been Tater ever since. In this particular pond, there's nothing but catfish, supposedly. We were here one day having a picnic, and over on the tables over there, and I said, George, I'm gonna fish for some bass. He said, there's no bass in this pond. I put a worm on it and dropped it down in the water about 2 feet, and wham, here come a bass, about 5 pound fish. And I drug him out and took to George, and I said, how'd this bass get in the spawn? He liked to die. He said, I didn't know there was a bass in the spawn at all. He must have been there years before I ever bought the pond.
Well, I thought that I'd caught a whale when he came up and stood on his tail. The big one would get away for sure. Somebody snapped a Kodak as we wrestled round and round. We'll never know how big he was, but the picture weighed 12 pounds.
Welcome back to Tennessee. I'm Justin Wolf. We're fishing country music legend George Jones's ponds for catfish with little Jimmy Dickens, who's already had success this morning.
Later that afternoon, we took the short drive to Tanya Tucker's ranch, where there are two ponds loaded with fish. We're joined by Connie Nelson.
Well, here we are at Tanya Tucker's pond. I've got little Jimmy's tackle box. That's my job.
And singer-songwriter Gary Schiebler.
I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to fish with one of these Gary Yamamoto Senkos here, this 208 4-inch. I know they bass love that. What you going to be fishing
I'm
with?
I'm putting on a night crawler. Because I've never seen the day that a fish didn't like a night crawler.
Now, what do you got, 75-pound test on here for
no,
a 2-pound bass?
No, it's a rope.
It's a rope, okay. You know, us guys from California, we fish that light line.
Yeah, I know what you folks in California do. You come down here to learn how to fish. That's what you do.
See, here we go.
Hey, dude.
Here we go. It's getting ugly.
Huh?
It's getting ugly.
No, that's just you and I talking.
Just you and me talking.
Yeah. Well, one time I was playing, doing a concert in Kingston, Arizona. And this man came to my show with a little girl. She was 8 or 9 years old. And he said, Mr. Dickens, my daughter sings. and she sings well. And I wonder if there's a possibility that you might put her on your program. And I said, well, certainly. And that was my first introduction to Tanya Tucker. She stole the show from me, and thereafter, I never put her on again. Oh, boy. How old is this little girl? Tanya Tucker's little daughter, showing us how to fish.
Sometimes I trick my brother and I say I got one, and he come running over here and he's like, you don't got one. And I'm like, no.
That's perfect.
We've had this ranch for about 10 years, and I was about 2 when we came here, and it's 500 acres, 2 ponds, you know, barn, everything, and they were already stocked when we came here. And we've kind of stocked them a couple times, but we actually drained one and then kind of stocked it back. And we're kind of just getting everything right now and starting to turn around, and fish are starting to bite better. But it's a great pond, and I've always loved it, and coming down here and getting away from things.
Oh, faithful had erupted for sure. When he shook his head and spit out the lure. Oh, Bobby Bear will never let me live it down. We'll never know how big he was, but the picture weighed 12 pounds. Now folks have framed that picture and hung it on the wall. I just sit and tremble and pray that it don't fall. This will be my story till it lay me in the ground. We'll never know how big he was, but the picture weighed 12 pounds.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.